Hello everyone, welcome to another video. In this video I'll talk about a game between Shimano and Kaerunen from 2013. I'm hoping this will be a part of a series about some qualities or nature of the game and how chess behaves in certain positions and so on. So let's move on to the game. The opening was a Vienna. I will not talk too much about the opening as it is, it will take a lecture on its own, and the players are following some kind of theory, and I think they are both familiar with what's going on. So the first movement, and now queen into c3, white plays king f1. Just to clarify, queen into c4 is a mistake because of king g1, and g into f6 allows rook c1, picking up the rook on h8 eventually. So that you don't really want that as black. But they are not thinking these things over the board, they are all prepared. And gf6, rook c1, queen a5. And now white plays g3, which is not the most popular move here, but it's a way to play. So the discussion is basically whether the capture of the pawn, black has an extra pawn, you can see, and white is aiming for more development, and black king is kind of stuck in the center. So even if it goes to the king side, it's not so clear whether it will be safe. And these are typical things for this opening. And you can say this is the discussion that's going on, and black plays bishop d7. So king g2, knight c6. So again here we see that black is trying to develop and white has to do something against it. And after knight b5, black plays knight e5. And now we have come to the critical moment of the game. And the game takes a certain direction from this point. Maybe even from knight b5, white is expecting this. And so now both these pieces are attacked. Knight on b5 and bishop on c4. And as I already said, white plays dependent a lot on the initiative and play against the king, so you cannot make defensive moves right now. You don't really want to do that. So every move from now on is actually a puzzle, which you can try to, for both sides actually, for both white and black, it is actually a puzzle, and you can try to figure out the moves depending on the level you are, but it will be quite difficult if you're starting out. So so now we cannot defend. Nobody wants to defend right now. So we have to do something aggressive to answer a threat with a threat. White plays queen d6. And so now the battle begins and conversation begins, whatever. So knight into c4 would not be such a good move because of knight c7, king d8, rook into c4. I preserve my knight, I attack your rook. So, and I've locked in your king in the center. So any move like rook c8 would lose to rook hc1. My next move is knight into e6 and rook c8 mate, because the bishop is pinned. So anything, let me just, for the sake of it, leads to mate. So black cannot really take this bishop right now, right? So so what else can he do? That's what we have to see. Rook c8 is a move, but also is bad because of bishop e2. And the king is kind of stuck in the center. And black has to solve this problem somehow, right? So he takes the material offered. So bishop into b5 was played. Bishop into b5, queen into b5. Generally, in such situations when everything is going bad for you strategically, at least you take the material and see if you can survive the strategic disadvantage. So rook c7 in this position. So if you look at this position now, this game was an important point in developing my understanding, I think. And to me, I didn't understand the first time I saw this game how black can be equal here, right? So both these rooks are not playing, and so the knight is not, I'm just playing with my knight and queen, and all these white pieces are coming into the attack. I'm not sure why black should be equal, and I'm still not sure why black is equal, but you know, it's just kind of the nature of the game where unless the opponent makes a mistake, you cannot change the assessment of the position. This is the fundamental law of chess, you can say. The assessment of the position changes only when your opponent makes a mistake. It does not change when you make some tremendous good moves or brilliant moves. Queen d6 would be a could be considered as a beautiful brilliancy also, but since black has not made a mistake, white cannot be better still. So black walks a thin line here. Of course, there is a practical advantage and so on, but both players were sufficiently prepared in this game. So let's see what is our problem as black right now, and that is queen e7 mate, as simple as that. And okay, let's find out the ways to stop it, right? So knight c6, knight d7, and knight g6. If you want to solve it as a puzzle, just think about it and solve it as a puzzle. But yeah, probably the first move that comes to mind is not the right move. So knight c6 is simple to see, loses to queen d7 and queen f7 mate, and knight d7 loses to the tactical idea, rook b1. So yeah, such things are bound to come. Queen a4, rook b4, and etc. Sorry, and white is winning, and white is checkmating black, probably. And so that leaves us with one move, and that is knight g6. But we have to ask ourselves the same question, right? What if I win with rook b1? Rook b1 is so tempting here, but it does not win. Can you see what black can do here? And he has a defense, pretty good one, and that is. So answering a threat with a threat again, you know, I have a threat, I'm going to answer that with a threat. Rook d8. So hitting the queen here, and this is how black saves him, and this is kind of an only move. So rook into b5 allows rook into d6, it doesn't make any sense. And queen into d8, king into d8, rook into b5 also doesn't make sense because of king into c. So black practically saves himself after this. So I can just probably take this even, and I'm winning, right? So yeah, so rook d1 doesn't work for us. So what should white do, right? So white brings another piece into the attack. White plays rook d1 here. White brings another piece into attack, and at the same time stops black plump from black's threat of rook d8. And yeah, and this is black's next move is incredible and a very difficult one to see actually, and kind of requires you to understand what is white's threat. So white basically wants to play here. He's threatening to continue the attack, you know, rook d4 and a4. Since I'm not able to go this way, I'm stopping rook d8, and rook d4 and a4 is my threat. So lot of tempting moves, but you can see that, you know, the reason why these slow ideas work is because I'm not able to bring both my rooks into play, and I'm unable to, my knight is held up and my queen is the only piece, but it cannot move also. You can see that none of this moves. So such a terrible position from optically, but apparently it's still equal, and that's because black has not made an objective mistake yet. This is just a law of chess, and I also don't know why this is equal, but it's, we have to accept some things in chess, and we cannot argue with some things. And if you ever win a game or if you lose a game, you have made a mistake, and yeah, that's that. You cannot win a game or lose a game without making a mistake. That's a fundamental law of chess. h5 is the move played, so it's not really an attacking move or something. The idea is to answer rook d4 with rook h7, saving this pawn, basically. And when you play a4, I'm free to move my queen somewhere, I suppose, and basically I'm not getting mated on f7. So it's more of a defensive idea. And so, yeah, so rook d4 doesn't work anymore for white. And he's given up a piece now. And what should he do? He's kind of has to find another idea now, and that is a4, queen a4, rook d7. Now I have another threat, and that is rook d7. So why didn't I play rook d7 immediately? Is because black plays queen b6, protecting d8, and then yeah, it doesn't work for white. I don't think this is what he wants. Even this, or rook h7, anything looks good for black. So, preventing the threat of queen b6, black, white plays rook d7. Black plays queen a5. Queen d4, moves like this don't help, guys, because we are losing sight of d8. And yeah, white's next move is just rook d8, and we don't want this. So, the most tempting way to play here is queen a5, right? So we want to protect this, but it doesn't really stop white from getting an advantage because of rook into b7. Now I'm threatening rook b8 check. Let's say rook d8. White plays rook d8, rook b8, king e7, queen d6, king e8, rook b1. And my threat is rook b8, which is kind of unstoppable. Even if black plays queen d8, I'm going rook b8, which is basically winning for me. So, yeah, so this is not good enough for us. And a brilliant move here actually saves the game for black. I would like you to see if you can find it. Take a moment to think about it, and moment is probably not enough. But yeah, if you want to use this potion as a game, as a training exercise, that would be also good for you, I think. Yeah, but the move, I'm about to show the move. And the move he played is actually, and the only move, is knight f. So the move needs some explanation, I guess. The first response, queen f4, is not so great because of queen d7, rook d7, king d7. And yeah, g into f4, not queen d4, king f1, queen h1, king e2, queen e4. We keep checking him, and he is not able to move to the d file because of queen d5 check. And he ends up in an endgame where he's 2 points down, and that's not really what white wants. So knight f4 check. Let me see. So I cannot take this guy with the pawn or the queen. So let me consider king moves now. The aggressive king f3. Now again, that's only move actually wins for black. Queen b3 check. King f4. E5 check. King f5. Queen f3 is mate. And queen b3 check, you cannot block because of queen d3 simply. So king f3 doesn't work. Let's look at the other king moves. King h1 doesn't work because black mates white on g2. Where else can I go? King g1 doesn't, it works, but it's just a repetition. So king f1 doesn't work because of, can you guys see it? It's geometry and beautiful. Queen a6 check. Hitting this. And only white can lose after queen into a6. Probably it will end in a draw, but yeah, white can lose it. Only white can. Black has no chance of losing. So that's the same reason why white cannot go king f1 here, because of queen a6 check. Exchanging the queens. So a fascinating game. Probably all of it was prepared at home, and I don't know personally these players. So, but this looks like a theoretical game rather than a practical game, but it also helps us understand something about chess. I think this was a game, and they made a draw here. Yeah, they made a draw like this, but this helps us understand something about chess, and that is, unless your opponent makes an objective mistake, you cannot be better, and you can change the assessment of a position from equal to white is better or black is better only when the opponent commits a mistake. White played some extraordinary moves here, I think, in this game. But black also did the same thing. And when your opponent does that, you're not going to end up with an advantage. This also leads to, gives rise to another rule, I think, that you cannot, what you're aiming for an from the opening is probably an imbalance rather than an advantage. If you're, so fundamentally, we're not preparing mistakes for the opponent. So we're aiming for an imbalance. And, you can, even in this position, let's say It would be very difficult for a player to hold this position just to, by playing over the board. I think probably black was prepared, and so was white, and they did, they played a perfect game, and a perfect game ends in a draw. But playing an imbalanced position over the board requires skill and mastery and understanding. So you can see that a lot of top guys can maybe play this position, but we don't know yet. I don't understand why, even after violating all the rules of basic principles, you know, why it should be equal. I don't know why it should be equal, but I just know that it can be equal, and there's a possibility that it's equal. And unless I have made a mistake, the position should be equal. So that is the first rule of chess. I wanted to share that, you know, unless there is a mistake, the assessment of the position cannot change. You cannot change the assessment of a position with a good move, but only with a mistake. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.